Is what you're doing supporting the end goal? I have three massive whiteboards in my bedroom. One has all my goals for the next 12 months, the other 24 months, and the third, the next 10 years. If I'm ever worried or unsure about a decision I have to make, I look at those three boards and ask myself, does this support the end goal? If the answer is no, I don't do it. If the answer is yes, I go all out with it. It's incredibly easy to get caught up in leading a busy life, to work harder and harder while climbing the ladder of success, only to discover it's leaning against the wrong wall. The three whiteboards are my way of making sure that the decisions I make are effective in moving up the ladder that's up against the right wall. People often find themselves achieving victories that are empty, success that has come at the expense of things they suddenly realize were far more valuable to them. For example, one of my main goals in life that probably trumps all others is having a strong enough relationship with my daughter so that I become her go-to person in life. My mum has always been my go-to person, and I want to be that person for my daughter. I know how to do this. I always need to be present when I'm with her. Up until the last couple of years, too often, I would find myself taking out my phone, scrolling through social media while in the company of other people. What's worse is they would be doing the same, and neither of us would see anything wrong with it. I remember reading The Willpower Instinct by Kelly McGonigal, where she talks about how it takes willpower to say no to things and how to be present with the people you care about the most. If you want a better relationship with someone, be it your partner, your parents, or your children, be present when you're with them. The book talks about a study done on husbands and fathers who were physically present at home for at least 6 hours a day, but spent the entire time either watching TV or working. In relative terms, this father or husband would be with his family for at least 6 hours, but he wasn't present for the majority or any of the 6 hours. In contrast, the study looked at husbands and fathers who were only home for 1 hour a day but spent the entire hour engaging with their families. There was no TV turned on in the background, there was no scrolling through social media, just quality family time where there was no distraction or quote-unquote noise.